Today, I am going to discuss about the law of karma from the professional ethics. So, welcome to my YouTube channel, Mechanical Engineering Management. So, let's see outlines of the session. So, first we will discuss about the origin of the law of karma. Then we will discuss about what is karma. Next, what is the law of karma? And at last, we will see three principles for law of karma. So let's start with the first point, origin of the law of karma. And from this figure, you can understand about the meaning or the concept of the law of karma. Here it is written, give what you would want to receive. That is the principle of karma. So now see, first of all, the origin of the law of karma. Karma is a Sanskrit word for action. Karma is an original Vedic thought which was later propagated and popularized by the teachings of Buddha and Mahavira. Now, let's see meaning of karma. Buddha states that karma consists of our thoughts, words, actions, and actions those are performed by other under our instructions. So, very simple, karma means our thoughts, words, actions, and the actions, those are performed by other under our instructions. Every task we do is karma. Karma is an activity which all the human beings have to perform until death. In fact, karma is the action or activity deliberately done with full knowledge and intention of execution, and also in expectation of certain results from them. In short, we can say karma means action or activity deliberately done with full knowledge and intention of execution, and also at the end of that, some expectation of certain results. So this is the meaning of karma. Now next, law of karma. The Shatpath Brahman explained the meaning of the karma as, while our bodies may die, the soul is eternal. And it continues its journey through many lifetimes. The soul creates a system of actions and reactions throughout these lives, forming a cycle of rebirth. So this is a very simple concept by Shatpath Brahman. Bodies may die, soul is eternal, and it continues its journey through many lifetimes. That is called as the cycle of rebirth. The totality of our actions and the reactions in these and the previous lives determine our future. The life has been given to man to sort out the consequences of the previous karma deliberately done in many past lives as well as in present life. So it is very simple. The life has been given to the man to sort out consequences of the previous karma and as well as in present life. Person who performed the action should receive the reaction always. The reaction is going to be exactly same. So if your actions are good, then definitely you will get the good reactions. Next, three principles for law of karma. Law of karma works on three principles. First, similar to Newton's law of action, every action has reaction. So if your actions are good, then definitely you will get the good reaction. If your actions are bad, then definitely you will receive the bad reaction from the others. When you cause pain, that comes back to you. And when make someone happy, that comes back to you as well. So here you can see, if you give something, then definitely you will receive. Here you can see actions and reactions are always same. And here you can see first give what you would want to receive from the others. That is the principle of karma. If you want to see more, then subscribe my YouTube channel and go to playlist. Thanks, my dear friends, for watching this video.